Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. In this video, we shall talk about heat conduction, which is one of the three heat transfer processes. The other two processes are convection and radiation. You will see several demonstrations on heat conduction through solid objects. We have learned that when there is a temperature difference between two objects, heat will flow from the hot one to the cold one. We are going to learn how the heat flow or heat transfer takes place. Experiments show that there are three heat transfer processes: conduction, convection, and radiation. Let's look at some cooking methods. Firstly, frying. When a slice of steak is placed on a hot pan, heat flows from the hot object, the pan, to the cold one, the steak, directly. Here, heat is conducted between objects in direct contact. The process is called heat conduction. Note that in heat conduction, although there is a transfer of heat, there is no transfer of matter. Secondly, steaming. A Korean way of serving seafood in front of the customers is getting popularity in Hong Kong. The cookware consists of a tower of steaming containers stacking on top of one another with water boiling underneath. Seafood like the scallop, clams, razorfish, abalone, shrimps and crabs are cooked by the rising steam. Heat flows from the hot objects, the steam, to the cold one, the food. Here, heat is transferred through a process called convection. Note that in convection, the heat transfer is accompanied by a transfer of matter. Finally, solar cooking. Cooking can be done without any fuel cost by harvesting the sunlight using a concave mirror. Heat flows from the hot object, the sun, to the cold one, the food. The process is called radiation. Unlike the other two processes, a medium is not necessary, not even air, in radiation. In fact, the space between the sun and our earth is a vacuum. Can you summarize the differences between the three heat transfer processes, conduction, convection, and radiation? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Please press the space bar to pause the video now and write down your answer. This table summarizes the differences between conduction, convection, and radiation. Some require a medium, some involve transfer of matter. In the rest of this video, we shall discuss heat conduction through solid. Look at the video. Some rods are being heated by a Bunsen burner. Consider the iron rod in black color. One end is so hot that it glows and gives out light, while at the other end, the temperature is low enough that the rest does not melt. Clearly, a huge temperature difference exists between the two ends, and conduction of heat takes place from the hot end to the cold end. Conduction also takes place between two objects. Now let's try a simple activity. Touch any furniture around you with your hands. Do you think the furniture is cooler or warmer than your hand? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Since your body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius, while the furniture is at room temperature of about 25 degrees Celsius, heat flows from your hands to the furniture through conduction. As energy is removed from you, you will feel cool. Is our sensation reliable? Now touch a wooden object and then a metal object. Do you feel the same on touching wood and metal? Metal objects such as iron handrails are cooler in comparison to non-metal objects such as your school bed. Since furnitures are in thermal equilibrium with the surrounding air, they must be at the same temperature. Consider the two blocks of the same size and in the same color, one made of aluminium and the other made of wood. Both students touching them said that the metal block is cooler. However, an infrared thermometer tells us that they are at the same temperature of 29.2 degrees Celsius. Why does metal feel cooler when touched? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Please press the space bar to pause the video and write down your answer. Metal is a better conductor of heat and it takes energy away from your hand more quickly. As energy is removed from you, you feel cool. This activity shows that human sensation of hotness is unreliable. This is also why thermometers are invented. Let's extend the experiment. A piece of ice is placed on each block. Do they melt at the same rate? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Results show that the ice on the metal block melts much faster than the one on the wooden block. Can you explain the result? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. As both blocks are hotter than the ice, heat will flow from the blocks to the ice. Since metal is a good heat conductor, the heat flowing away from the metal block is faster. In other words, the ice is heated by the metal block at a higher power than by the wooden block. Let's try another experiment. The apparatus used include a cylindrical block which consists of two parts, iron and wood, a piece of paper, a cello tape, and a Bunsen burner. Wrap the cylinder with the paper with the dotted die along the junction. Now hold the cylinder above the flame of the Bunsen burner. Move the block to and fro so that the junction is heated uniformly. After a while, you will see that one half of the paper turned brown, while the other half remained intact. Can you explain this in terms of heat conduction? Pause the video for a while and answer the question. Since metal is a good heat conductor, as soon as the paper is heated, the absorbed energy is passed to the metal quickly. Therefore, the temperature of the paper remains low. On the other hand, wood is not a good heat conductor. The paper absorbs the heat but cannot pass it to the wood. Therefore, its temperature rises continuously. When it reaches the paper ignition temperature of 451 Fahrenheit or 233 degrees Celsius, it starts to burn. The following experiment is decided to study how the rate of heat conduction varies with materials. The apparatus includes four rocks of the same dimension but different materials: iron, copper, aluminium, and glass. It also includes a tripod, wax, joint pins, and a Bunsen burner. Adhere a joint pin to one end of each rock by melt wax. A Bunsen burner is pasted under the other ends of the rocks. When heat is conducted to the far end, the wax will melt and the joint pins will fall. Results show that the rate of heat conduction in descending order of materials is copper, aluminium, iron, and glass. How do we explain heat conduction in terms of molecular motion? In a solid, molecules are closely packed. They are vibrating about their equilibrium positions, and they often collide with one another. The molecules near the hot end have more kinetic energy and vibrate more. Some of their kinetic energy will be transferred to adjacent molecules through collisions, causing other molecules to vibrate more. Since the average kinetic energy of molecules increases with temperature, the other part of the solid will be heated up. As a result, heat is conducted along the solid. Why is metal a better conductor than non-metal? In a metal, electrons are loosely bounded by the ions. They are known as free electrons. When a metal is heated, both ions and electrons gain kinetic energy. Unlike the ions, free electrons can move quickly to the colder region and transfer their energy there by collision. This explains why metal are good conductors of heat. Question: consider the following experiment. Two aluminium rods of the same length are stuck with a joint pin at one end using melted wax and the other end heated by a Bunsen burner. Will the joint pins fall at the same time? If not, which one will fall first? Explain your answer. Be the first to write your answer in the comments below. You are welcome to comment on the answers of other people. In summary, conduction is the process in which heat is transferred through a body from the hot end to the cold end. It also occurs between two bodies in contact. When you hold a cup of hot tea, you feel warm. We say that heat is transferred to your hand through conduction. Materials which conduct heat are known as heat conductors. Metals are good heat conductors, and silver is the best. Materials which conduct heat poorly are called heat insulators. In general, non-metals such as glass and wood are heat insulators. A vacuum cannot conduct heat at all. In the next video, we shall talk about the heat conduction through liquid and gas. I hope this video can help you understand more about heat conduction. Thank you for watching.